Mabel joins me. It's so good to see you.
Hi, thank
congratulations
you
on your Brit nomination. This
thank
is
you.
So exciting. So it's next week.
Yes.
How are you feeling about it?
Really nervous, but also just excited. Obviously, just the nomination alone is amazing. It's a voted category, so people can vote for
of
me
course.
By going to the Brits website, brits.co.uk.
Which
you can
is
still
great.
Vote, so please vote.
But that's really good because that shows you win that award, and that's the award that people have actually gone to the trouble
exactly.
of voting for. So it probably means a lot more, I guess.
Yeah, it does mean a lot, you know, obviously, that the fans get to sort of say how they feel.
I didn't know you were born in Malaga.
Listen, I've lived all
You've
over.
Lived everywhere. Matt, I love it. It's one of my favourite cities. It's an amazing
city. Oh, it's so
city.
Beautiful.
It's brilliant. It's so vibrant. There's so much going on there. And then you lived in London. You've been in Sweden. So I guess from all of that and from your parents, the influences you must have and the things that you can draw in the different cultures.
Yeah, I think like where you are affects what you're creating.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And I have all these like amazing places that I can draw inspiration from and family all around the world. Yeah, very lucky.
Were you writing your own stuff and performing when you were tiny? Was it just something that you always did?
I just loved performing when I was a kid. I always used to like put on these shows in our living rooms and like invite people to watch these like absurdly long shows of me just like singing and dancing from when I was super young. And then when I was like 5, I started playing piano and like journaling and sort of connected the dots that like, my feelings with chords, like that's how you write music. And I think that my creative expression is like the same now.
That's incredible. In a way to be expected, because you grew up in a house of music, of course. Mum and dad both musicians, as we know. And that, I had no idea that Nina Cherry was your mum.
I've really like paved my own way in terms of my career and done it all by myself. So yeah, it's cool.
I bet it is. You've got the coolest mum in the world, for goodness sake. And then how did the whole kind of thing with Harry Styles come about? Because I know you supported him on his tour.
Yeah,
and that's massive.
It was amazing.
Really massive. Hard in a way, because of course everybody's there to see him. But in a way, if you can win over even a small proportion of that audience, that's incredible.
You're Harry fan.
Which you did. I think they're great. I think they're, I mean, they're a little bit young for me. Just a wee tiny bit. But I get it. I understand why they're so popular. Of course I do.
Yeah.
But had you known each other? How did that come about?
I've worked with a producer quite a lot that he works with. And so we met like once before I went on tour. And then I think, you know, with his solo career, he's really like done it himself.
Sure.
And like there was like a few of us supporting. So I did the European leg of the tour.
Mm.
And it was just really obvious that he's chosen artists that he himself actually really likes. And yeah, he's a lovely guy.
And that makes perfect sense. You're like his little sister, I think. You're like brother and sister. Did he not put a pie in your face at one point?
Cheeky monkey. My goodness. I still finished the show with the pie all over my face.
What a professional. What a professional. I love it. I love it.
Yeah.
No, it's good.
Quite an experience.
Good. Because guys at that level, they don't know. Most people are just after them just for who they... Most people, not all, because they're famous, because they're rich and all of that. But you're not, because you don't need to be. And you're just his friend. And I think that's absolutely lovely. Also, the fact that you wrote music when you were tiny and you said that you kept a journal, which I think is really important. But it really helped you because, like so many young people, and it's great you talk about it, you have had anxiety.
For sure.
And that's really helped you with that. Writing down your feelings, just writing them down.
It was just my way of, expressing it and getting things off my chest. And I think, you know, just talking about it, for me, is like 80% of feeling better. So I, like, hope that by talking about it, other people talk about it too. And, you know, I think a lot, like, the generation sort of below me with the, like, social media and, like, it's a lot of pressure just growing up in general.
I know.
And, like, going through puberty and trying to figure out who you are with all the added pressure of, like, looking at things on Instagram and being like, should I be wearing this? Should I be doing this? And which is why I think it's important to talk about.
And I think that's why so many young women and young men really relate to you and relate to what you're saying to them. Of course they do. Of course they do. Look, best of luck next week.
Thank you.
Mum has got 2 Brits.
I know. No pressure.
No pressure at all. Do you know what? You've got the rest of your life. The rest of your life you really have. Mabel, a joy.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
You.
And the single's doing brilliantly. Number 5 right now, I believe.
I can't believe it. Yeah, 2019 so far is amazing.
Ah,
I'm very happy.
It'll just get better and better for you, I'm
Thank
sure.
Thank you.